Hello, I am Ivan, and in this video I will show how I prepare my building surface with ABS slurry. Then we will test how most common filaments adhere to this surface. The most important things you need: glass with the dimensions of your heated bed, painting adhesive tape, empty jar, brush, some ABS leftovers from your prints, and acetone. First, stick the tape to the glass. Get as large tape as possible to make this process faster. Then chase the air bubbles. You can use a plastic cart to clean any air bubbles remaining. Pour a small quantity of acetone in the jar, like 50-60 milliliters. Then put some ABS leftovers, like 20-30 grams. Close the jar and churn for about 5 to 10 minutes. The ABS starts to dissolve. If the solution is too washy, put more ABS into it. If it is too dense, put more acetone. The ABS slurry should have density similar to this one. Now we have to paint on the tape. To speed the process, you may use a sponge or another expandable object to distribute the ABS slurry. You will be able to make only few moves because the solution dries fast. Then use the brush to cover the empty areas. Here is the moment to say that as the acetone evaporates, you will be exposed to its vapors. Acetone is flammable and it is toxic, but it is not highly toxic. Exposure via the eyes and the nose and the mouth is the main risk. Some skin effects may occur, but they are minor and generally arise only after long-term exposure. So, please work with acetone in a ventilated area outside, or at least open your window. I saw some people make a much thinner layer of ABS juice, but I prefer more plastic because it is more solid and it has best work for me. So, after finishing the paint job, let it dry for 30 minutes. When completely dry, you will see that the surface that was kind of irregular when painting has become quite smooth. Mount the glass on your printer. If you don't use sensor for leveling, please level your bed. Now we are ready to test print. For the test, I was looking for a fast yet useful print and found this Rocket Tech holder at Thingiverse. I will download it and I will prepare the slicing files in Simplify 3D. We'll test the surface with the three most common filaments: ABS, PETG and PLA. All parts will be printed with no raft, no brim and no supports. For the PLA, no issues. It is the most easy filament to print with. Here I am at 50 degrees Celsius for the bed and 210 for the hot end. It sticked fine, no warping, and printed nicely. Let's change the filament. I will print the PETG next. For PETG, I use Hertz. It is a German brand, made I think in Hungary, and is very good for its price. The price is about 23 euro for 1 kilogram. So this print went very well as well. I print with hot end at 240 degrees and I raise the bed temperature to 80 just for the first layer to assure good adhesion. Then I turn it off so it's quite energy efficient. Change the filament again. I will be printing the ABS last. The brand is Hertz again. It gave me more consistent results than other budget filaments. I think the ABS is around 19 euro for a kilogram. I print it at 250. Regarding the bed temperature, I could do just like for PETG and heat it only for the first layer. It will stick fine on the ABS slurry. However, when printing ABS, the surrounding temperature should be around 50 degrees and it has to be maintained in order to avoid layer separation when the ABS is cooling. So basically I keep my bed heated at 90 all the time in order to maintain the temperature inside the enclosure. So all three prints went well and have been solidly stick to the ABS slurry. If you have warping issues with any of these three types of filament, consider trying this do-it-yourself solution. Thanks for watching.